Miss Radha invested ₹9,600 for 3 years at 10% per annum at compound interest. CA is a compound interest. First question is, what is the sum due at the end of first year? That is the first question. Second question, what is the sum due at the end of the second year? Third question is, find the difference between the answers 2 and 1. What is this difference between 2 and 1? And find the interest on this sum for 1 year. So calculate the difference and find the compound interest. Okay, what is the interest on the sum for 1 year? The third question is, find the compound interest for the third year. Find the difference, find the compound interest. Then you calculate what is the third year interest. Okay. Here, the principal amount P is equal to ₹9,600. Okay. And the R is equal to 10%. R is equal to 10. N is equal to 3. Okay. For 3 years. Here, N is equal to 3. We should not put 3, we have to put 1, first year. Next year, n is equal to 1, third year n is equal to 1, okay. N is equal to 1. So, we have to calculate simple interest. SA is equal to PNR by 100 or PTR by 100. P is 9,600 and R is equal to 10, N is equal to 1. Divided by 100, therefore these two terms get cancelled. Simple interest is ₹960. Okay, that is the simple interest. So Radha get at the end of the first year is in the compound interest is 960. What is the accumulated amount? Accumulated amount is equal to principal plus interest. What is the principal? 9,600. Plus 960. So that is equal to 10,560. So Radha's accumulated amount at the end of first year is ₹10,560. Okay. Next we go for a second year. What is the principal? Principal P is equal to 10,560. So that is the principal amount. Okay. Rate of interest 10. R is equal to 10. N is equal to 1. Second year. Okay. Again, we calculate simple interest. So 10,560 into 10 into 1. By 100. So these two terms will cancel. The 1056 rupees. Rupees 1056 rupees. 1056. That is the simple interest received by Radha at the end of second year. Okay. What is the accumulated amount? Accumulated amount is equal to, again, principal plus interest. What is the principal? Principal is 10,560 plus 1056. That is equal to 611611. 11,616. So 11,616 is the amount we received at the end of second. This is rupees 11,616 is the amount he received at the end of the second year. Okay. The third question, find the difference between answers 2 and 1. So answer 2 and 1 we have to calculate. Find the difference. The difference is difference is equal to, what is this, is 11,616 minus 10,516. So that is the value. That value is, okay, we calculate 11,616 minus 10,516. That is equal to 1056. The answer is 1056 rupees. 1056. So that is the difference. Again, we have to calculate the find the interest on the sum for 1 year. So this we have to calculate the compounded interest for 1 year. Again, here the principal P is equal to this. This is P. Okay, P. N is equal to 1, R is equal to 10. Okay, simple interest is equal to 1056 into 10 into 1 divided by 100. Okay, these two terms get cancelled. You get the interest is 105.60 rupees. 105.60 is the interest for the difference. So this is the important thing. Okay, find the, this is the third question answer. Find the compound interest for the third year. What is the compound interest for the third year? Okay, we have to calculate the compound interest. Compound interest. Interest for the third year. Third year. Third year. That is equal to, that is equal to, what is the second year interest? Second year compound interest is 1056. Rupees 1056 plus, what is the interest for 1056? That is 105.60. So this is 60.11611. Okay, that is 1161.60 rupees. The compound interest for the third year. Compound interest for the third year is 1161.60 rupees. Okay, so the first question answer is, this is the first question answer. First question, what is the sum duty at the end of the first year? So this is the first question answer. What is second question answer? Sum due to the second year. Sum due to the second year is this question. This is the second question. Third question, find the difference between the answers to. This is the third question answer. Okay, and find the interest on the sum for 1 year. So we have to calculate the interest on the sum for the 1 year. This is the second question. Sorry, this is the third question answer. This is also the third question answer. Fourth question, find the compound interest for the third year. The compound interest is 1161. This is the fourth question answer. So this way you have to work out this problem. First you have to understand the problem, then you have to. Thank you.